Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Young Baki. You're doing the B-side show for him, the State of Battle Rap. We get together once a month and discuss exactly that, the State of Battle Rap. With me today, go ahead and introduce yourself, man.
What's poppin'? It's your boy, Cali Boy, baby.
What's up, man? It's your boy, Knock Steady.
Gunter, Manos, Mantos, from Graveyard.
Yo, man, I'm going to thank you for filling in. You know what I'm saying? Psychosis had little call issues, and today you came through with the audible, man. So I'm happy you're here. We're all happy you're here. Knock said he didn't want you on the show, but I stuck up for you anyways. So
it's all good.
Nah, I'm saying. Yo, Cali, like I was saying, man, right before you went on, I'm super excited to finally have you here. I've been trying to get you on the show for a couple months now, man.
Yeah,
so,
dope,
yo, how you feeling? I know, you know, everyone knows you were involved in that car accident. How you feeling, man? You back 100%?
I ain't 100%, but I'm there. I'm getting there. A few more weeks, you feel me? But I went on my first hike again today. Like I said, it's like my fourth day without wearing my sling. So it's all in the progress, you feel me?
I feel you, man. You said you got a battle in Hawaii coming up?
Yeah, a battle in Hawaii. Let me find a venue real quick in my phone. A battle on the big island of Hawaii on the 18th of July.
Which one's the big island?
It's called Hawaii. And then I have a battle on the island of Oahu the next day. So it's two battles in Hawaii. And I'm going to get busy in both.
Man, I don't think there's much people that battle more than you. You know what I'm saying? It seems like every time I look up, you got another battle. After you have the URL Blooming Crowns, correct?
Yeah.
Who you going against over there?
Emerson Kennedy, my boy EK. That's the homie, too.
Nice, man.
You know, you got to battle. You gotta teach your homies a lesson sometimes.
I feel you, man. Yo, Dante, you just had an event this past weekend. What was the name of your event?
Yo de las Barras, Guerra de Dioses.
I have no chance pronouncing any of your events, man. Every time I even try to pronounce the league, I embarrass myself. So, yo, man, who got the battle tonight? Who battled? What happened?
We had Dr. Settle and Lil B over from New York. That was a dope-ass battle. We had Germ Free versus Top Dime, which from the Top View Cypher Effect, Germ Free.
Joan Free got that one. I've only seen one Joan Free battle. I think there's only one battle, right? I haven't seen a battle in those.
Yeah, she battled King of the Dot.
Yeah, when she battled Bonnie, right?
Yeah. So that was in English. She did way better in Spanish. She fucking bodied.
Man, I didn't even know she speaks Spanish.
I didn't know that either.
You look like you're pretty drunk right now, dude.
Nah, I'm chilling.
Slap me that lighter, bro.
Yo, man. Knock, what's up with you, man? I actually stopped by your event a couple weeks ago. You know what I'm saying? Had in my hometown. Not my hometown, but you know what I'm saying? Might as well be my hometown, North Hollywood.
Yeah.
Looked like you had a good little turnout. I was insulted that, you know, you come to North Hollywood, you come to a Young Baka Productions venue, you don't reach out to, you know, Young Baka, but it's all good.
You know what? I didn't know about it either. I was thinking the same thing. Like, he ain't let me know neither.
You stuttered, man.
I mean, unless you're in the inner circle of my life, I mean, I stepped back from a lot of day-to-day, like, battle rap shit. You feel me? It's just like, I've been more laid back. I've been doing progressing and trying to have more of a something to put on the table, you know what I mean? Because when an individual see you on the internet, they just want to tell you, you know, and label you, oh, you so-and-so fan or whatever, you know what I mean? But everybody has their own movement. As far as grind time and a lot of things
that was the grind time of fans, right?
Yeah, it was. Okay. Yeah, well, we combined with a lot of ventures with, like, Versus MC, which is, you know, a battle rap app. It's a platform for individuals, you know, to, you know, download something, and whether it's an Apple, Android, you know what I mean, you get on the battle scene. So I've been trying to progress on those type of levels where you move into a business sense with the business, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, when Baka reached out to me, it's crazy because when you reached out to me, I was like, "This, I know he's not trying to book me for a rap battle."
I didn't even know you. Do you battle? Have you ever battled before?
Hell yeah! I know you've seen my fucking whack ass.
I don't think I have, dude. You know, I've seen Dentist whack ass battles, but I don't think I've seen yours.
Damn, he got it. You know what I mean? Hell no.
Yo, but, man, you know, go ahead, I don't mean to cut you off, man. Go ahead, finish what you gotta say. You know how much heat I get? I don't want to say every day, but at least three times a week, I get heat for picking when I judge your battle against Carter Deans.
You still get heat?
I get heat from that. You picked Carter Deans too, though, right?
You chose Carter Deans.
You get heat. I think he won, but I get heat.
Why do you get heat for him?
I think I get heat
because they speak Spanish when they talk shit to you?
Nah, man. I think his style of battling is really popular with some fans, and some fans are more about the lyrics and more about the question. They don't like it. You know what I'm saying?
Did you judge him versus Irvin?
No, I did not. I did not.
That's why I remember.
No. Orban actually, I think you laid down the blueprint for Orban's battle, because he came with that super aggressive, how do you guys let him represent the West Coast? How do you let him get away with this bullshit? Kind of what you picked up in the third round. If you would have gone all three rounds with that aggression, I think you would have got it, man.
Good thing Baca wasn't judging that battle.
Nah, man. You think you beat Carter Deems that night?
I think I could have done better. I wasn't.
So do you think you beat him? Yes or no?
Good guy either way.
That's
me.
Why I kept
so
it on
the fact that it's even close, you can't really blame anybody. You know what I'm saying? If you make it close, it's on you. What's up, man?
No, I'm just saying that. You know what I mean? That's just not biased, but you know what I mean? On that night, Carter Deems was just had the rebuttal for the rebuttal with a side of a rebuttal. You know what I mean? He covered too much ground on every single topic that was supposed to be brought up, and it was, you know, in a sense. So. You know what I mean? That's why battle rappers need to fall back from just the persona image and just.
Did you beat Carter Deems?
I just asked him.
I lost. Oh, you lost.
Yeah, Baca judged that.
Yeah, it was the pre.
You know, Knox judged it too.
Both of these guys judged that.
People come to me like I made a decision I was only judge.
I mean, what I think it was his
Carter
first battle.
Deems don't want no smoke.
It was his first battle. People were excited to see him. After that, it kind of wears down. And plus, he's battling like Illmac and. Head eyes, so yeah. he don't really give a fuck anymore about
did you,
the tourney.
Did you see him against Illmac? Cali?
I was there, but I didn't get to see the battle. I heard about it.
I heard it was amazing. That's, I haven't seen it yet. I got the pay-per-view at home. I still haven't watched it.
I got the pay-per-view too, and I didn't see that battle exactly.
You're not off.
But I went and saw the bar that they was tripping on, and it was performed better than it was written.
Is it battle rap 90% performance?
Yeah, it is.
So then he's doing.
Because I just served John the Don, and there's actually people out there. People saying I won, but it's actually people out there saying that he won rounds and stuff.
I'm confused. Where you battled John that? What league was that for?
It was for Infamous Battles, but it was like a Rap Grid and Infamous Battles. Okay. Like they kind of did. They collaborated.
And so you saying you bodied him?
Man, John is a dope lyricist. I'm a fan of his. All that, bro. But if you
win or not, I won.
Dancing. I won, like, especially like if you
throw your body back, Cali over John.
2-1.
Man, it wasn't
3-0.
It was.
I think it was 3-0.
Look. I'm not an arrogant dude.
Are you
but
a
that
liberator?
Battle?
Like,
but that battle, look, that battle, I battled him like. Four weeks after the hospital.
You take a lot of selfies. You must be a little bit.
I was fresh out of the hospital when I did that battle. You feel me? I still had a broken arm, a broken shoulder. I couldn't even yell. I was a whole different person tonight than you staring at right now. You feel me?
And I still delivered and I still did my thing.
Like I credit all that. I see all that and like. You know, it's just a determination, you feel me? It was just a drive that I see that's like, bro, I can't nobody say you won a round in that. You feel me? He did two battles that day, and I respect that. But he
who
did
was his
choke.
Second battle against?
He did prep. He battled prep that day. And he choked against me. I didn't choke, you feel me? I started rebuttaling in the third round. I rebuttled like 6 bars or like 8 bars, you feel me? Strong, no slip-ups, you feel me? And he choked, and I feel like, man, people are crediting him for doing the 2 battles in one day. Yeah. People are bigging that up, and it's like, yo, y'all don't even know what I was going through.
Yeah. I think if you say 2 battles, that shouldn't come into
play. He battled in New York and flew out to Cali and battled
Cali. The
same
night, right?
Yeah.
That's pretty dope, though. You got to admit, that's pretty dope.
He choked, though.
That's pretty dope, man. Yo, man, speaking of, you know, you went to sleep and everything, everyone that doesn't know, explain what happened. You were involved in a car accident.
Yeah, you know, or whatnot, you know. Things happen.
Yeah, I feel you.
Yeah, you know.
So, with that being said, you seen the John versus Cali battle?
Yeah, man. I mean, I get
into your body bag.
Get into it. And I mean, from both sides and angles and shit, they could all come better. But Cali, he's been nice since like for a minute. So, like.
And that was my worst ever performance on record. I'll say that on record, too.
And I bet.
That was my worst ever, but it was my best, if you know the back. You feel me? If you know the backstory, it was the best. It was the best. It told the whole story. I was skinnier than I am now, smaller, everything. Couldn't even do it like I do it. You feel me? But I feel like, man, It told a story. Watching that battle is like watching Rocky 3 for me. You feel me?
I feel you, man.
But at what point you felt like you had just had that battle, though? Like, you know what I'm saying? Is there a specific point you feel like that?
I feel like the first round, me and John, it was the second time where Rocky fought Clubber Lang. And it was the beginning when they was locking. You feel me? Me and John was locking. And then the second round, he choked. So I dropped him. Boom. But he got back up in the third round. And it was like, all right, is Clubber Lang going to come knock him out? Or is Rocky going to drop him again? And then third round, we went the distance. And it was a 10-8 battle. Cali Smooth.
Yo, you didn't finish saying what was going on with Quiet Time. So are you guys, this is what I see with Quiet Time once in a while. You guys do an event, it's, you know, it has a little bit of buzz on it, then you guys disappear for 6 months. You have an event again out of nowhere, and then you disappear for 6 months.
The thing is with that,
Enlighten us, man.
You already know this, like, a lot of history with the whole Grind Time name. And, you know what I mean? I've spoken to Josh many times. And he's about more beyond the point. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's already past what they've been trolling on for years. You know what I mean? Like, for a lot of times, like, you know, the internet is a very powerful tool. Like, especially if you give it to some wise individuals, they come up with dope individual concepts that build. Or if you give it to the fucking general population of trolls, they're just gonna fucking inflame.
That's 95% of the internet, though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it is what it is. You gotta live with it.
You know,
there's
that dead zone that you just become a meme. You know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? You out there and you get trolled to death on stupid subject.
Do you feel like Quiet Time gets trolled a lot, even today in 2015?
That's what I told you, man. I for a long time, I mean, a testament, I fell back because I just got more into just like trying to build. I'm getting this whole little sneaker shit popping. Getting back into like battle rap, and I see on the group pages are gangbanging against each other, tripping on each other. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, I come back, I'm like, yo, what's up, y'all? And so if you're the admin on that group, you can't fuck with this group because that group, I mean, it's just a whole lot of,
I mean,
like,
there's a lot of history. There's a lot of history with a lot of people involved in different, you know, battle leagues, bring in, you know, like, King of the Dog, Prime Time.
I mean,
it is what it is, you know what I'm saying?
All those events, I mean, like I said, they can't take nothing away from Travis and for what Josh and what Lush made. You know what I mean? They general salute that. You know what I mean? You know, what we're growing with is what is the next business move like if we're going to get stuck in this whirlwind of internet, or are we going to just move on forth into individuals like Cali Smooth? Like, you know what I mean? They get money. You know what I mean? Like, real money. I'm talking about, like, you know, they have Diddy and all them in the stands. They love, you know what I mean? Rappers love bars and shit. Like, so this is our sport. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Snoop involved in the game.
Yeah,
too.
Snoop. Yeah, man. Snoop like, came heavy the last
can't
last,
sleep on that part.
The last couple months, man.
Yeah, he shows stupid love.
So who's involved? Who's in charge of Quiet Time at this current moment? Who's the president of Quiet Time? Who makes all the decisions?
Josh, look, man, the thing is, he moves at a strategy that is kind of like we spoon-feeding us back into the general pop. You know what I mean? Not trying to be all in your face and we hit you with so much pub of shows. Because we know what the territory is.
Isn't
man.
That you how say, you have to do it,
right
though?
Here,
don't you got to
well,
hit
this
him,
is the Fresh
don't
Coast,
you got to hit him
mean?
Over the head over and over
I
again?
Mean,
you know what I'm saying?
The Fresh Coast is in a conglomerate of a whole California. It's just like, you know what I mean? Lush know and shit. Like, when we have conversations on setting up events, like, you know what I mean? It's all about not stepping on toes. Because, you know what I mean? It's always about marketing, especially that, like, you don't want to book like a nice event and then like 3 weeks later it's going to be a really super nicer event because obviously the other you know camp have more, you know, chips on the table. So
yeah
it's all about getting your bread up to really be in that conversation back with the general pop, like I'm saying. So Josh is smart and shit, like, you know what I mean? Like, a lot of people think like, oh, he's just really really falling back, but Grind Time in areas like the southern eastern of United States, outside of the country, it's still pop. So they still watch. I mean, like, especially too, like, you know what I mean?
And you still have a gang of subscriptions, you know what I'm saying?
Of course.
So, I mean, so who is the president of Crying Time? Who makes all the decisions? Man, just
Matt Ills.
Okay, man, cool.
My boy, Josh.
I'll make sure. That's what you said, I keep you be coming over here like, yo,
first name
my boy
basis.
Travis is killing the game right now, obviously. The dude at home living in Mississippi doesn't know what you're talking about right now. It's all good, man. It's all good.
No. But, I mean, it's like on a first name basis. It's like so natural.
I feel you, man. Yeah.
I mean, especially when
you've been
talking
in the game for
guys.
So long. You feel me?
Shadows and shit. It's all about shadows.
What's going on with you, man? You killing the game. I'm super proud of you. You're like my son that I've raised. You know what I'm saying? So
you
what's
feel
going
like
on,
Big
man?
Lyric right now.
Nah, man. Why every show that comes up, every show Big Lyric comes
every
up.
Every show
it,
the
it
same thing comes
me
up.
Fucking insane, dude. Fucking insane. You should see when the same room together. He tries to sun me like he's like, yeah, you know, I put Bach on the game and everything. Anyways, back to my original question. What's going on with your league, man? First of all, how do you pronounce your league? Because every time I'm talking to somebody about it, I can't pronounce it.
Velorio.
Velorio.
Spanish Battle Rap League in U.S., the first one. Shit's popping off.
Oh,
it's crazy right
man,
now.
And you ain't seen these offense? These fans are crazy, dude.
You got to break down.
Send dogs up in the building. I've seen the pictures, man. I haven't been invited, but you know, it is what it is.
Yo, you don't go. Hey, both of y'all whack, because y'all both be having events. Don't send your boy no invitations. Don't book a nigga like
bro. I can't just go invite the whole battle rap world if they don't know
every time I'm trying to hit up him.
You don't hit up nobody. You don't even promote your offense. Your offense just pop up all of a sudden.
I love Latinas. I'll go check it out.
It's dope. It's dope though. Shit's cracking. I'm going out to Mexico in a couple months.
Gonna have going out July, man, right?
That's my girl.
August 1st, I'm gonna have a huge, huge battle out there. Probably like the Loaded Lux of Mexico out there with him.
You are the Loaded Lux of Mexico?
No, I'm battling.
I was gonna say way to be humble about it, right?
No, I'm battling the Loaded Lux of Mexico.
What's his name, man?
Aptos.
Ethos. Yo, man, I know we were talking last time you actually came to the show, and you were telling me in Mexico it's insane. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's 300, 500 people, man.
No.
I was going to say 1,000.
Thousand.
That was a
ghetto trap.
Yeah, 5,000.
Yeah, they have summer madness crowds that, bro.
He
like,
showed me some video. You see niggas.
I'm going to Mexico August 1st, battling like their top dog. So it's going to be huge out there. It's probably like a...
What?
Probably like a 500,000 viewed battle. It's
man,
gonna be,
dude.
It's going to
so,
be dope.
So,
hey,
correct
hey, that's
me.
Dope. Hey, I'm proud of you too now.
Yeah,
actually.
Man.
Now I feel like you're the son I raised from distance too now.
So, correct me. They have about 5,000 people at the event, right?
About 3,000, 2,000. 3, they got a
huge
smack crowd over there. It's crazy.
Man, why do you think it took so long for that to trickle up to the United States? Why did it take so long for that to happen?
It's just so many people out there that need their focus on something else other than the things going down in the country. So they just focus on hip-hop right now. Hip-hop's in the 90s state down there right now. Like, all over South America, Mexico is 90s state. Awesome. Like, they're
burning your bars, bro. Spit that shit.
No, they got some real shit, though. I'm fluent with Spanish, I understand that shit. It's very, you know what I mean?
I don't know what they be saying, but it looks like dude be killing it, man.
I got
the videos I've seen.
Battling in Spanish. I got a couple
for you.
Are you doing
punchlines really
and, like, schemes in Spanish?
We're the first ones doing it, introducing it to them. They're like when Grind Time started. They're transitioning from freestyle to written, so they still don't get the punchline and bars and all that shit right now.
Oh, really?
So we changing the game right now. They haven't heard us. Like, they haven't heard shit. Like
evolving this. It down there.
Wow.
So it's like overcrowding. Like, the United States is overgrowing it down there.
How did you specifically get involved in it?
I mean, it was like 2-3 years ago when I thought, like, man, this English shit is so saturated.
You're like,
right
this
now.
English
like,
shit ain't working out for me.
Nah, it's so saturated. Like, it's so hard to come up. Yeah. And, like,
it's too oversaturated.
It hasn't even been half a year that I've been doing the Spanish shit, and look where I'm at. I'm
man, it's buzzing.
Doing some crazy shit right now. Like,
it's buzzing, dude.
So you just did a Spanish battle? Seth,
no, like, I created a Spanish league.
He has a Spanish league.
Out here.
I'll be honest, I didn't even know you were ahead of it.
Every battle reaches around 15K, 20K. The most is like around 100.
How many events have y'all had?
We had three.
That's
they be popping, man. They be popping. See, isn't it crazy? Right. Like, everyone's proud of Dental. Like, oh, man, that's dope, Dental. That's dope. I didn't even know you were ahead of it, to be honest with you. A couple months ago, when I was booking for the show, I told Epic, I said, yo, who's ever in charge of the Spanish league? I want him on my show. He said, Dental. I said, yeah, Dental's cool, but I want who's in charge of the Spanish league. And he said, no, Dental's in charge of it. And I was shocked, man. So, once again, man, congratulations.
I just keep a low profile.
That's dope, man. I mean, that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to be behind the scenes, you know what I'm saying?
Bro, act like Floyd Mayweather.
You're not supposed to name your company Young Pac Productions to be all up in the videos and shit. If we're being honest about it, you know what I'm saying? That's not really what you're supposed to do. So how was your event this past weekend, man?
Oh, it was crazy. It was dope. A lot of fucking dope-ass battles. I mean, we had the biggest Cypher Effect viewed battle, which is Germ Free and Tata, that we're on that Cypher Effect.
What's the Cypher Effect viewed battle? What's
the
Cypher
Effect
battle?
Girl battle. It's the most viewed one. It's like a mil, almost two mil.
Oh, you're saying they battle
each
other.
Yeah, they were on that Cypher, and they battle each other in Spanish on our league.
Not Cypher Effect on the show, but it's all good. Go ahead. Continue what you're saying, man.
Yeah, but they battled. I mean, that shit's going to be huge when we release it. It was a body.
So who got it, man? I heard some stories. I had a couple people texting me while I was, you know, I was over here doing my
body.
I was in fucking Corona.
Germ-free
stuck
got
in Corona.
It.
How I was convinced to go to Corona to do battles, I don't know, but yeah. Go ahead, man. Don't let me stop you. Corona, you ever been to Corona before?
I've never been. I was telling them I was
like, You ain't missing much. You ain't missing much.
Just keep driving that 91 player and you'll get there.
Yeah.
You'll go down.
Yeah. It's insane. Dude, there was chickens on the side of the road, but it's all good. Wow. We're going off in a whole different subject.
North Hollywood, nothing like that.
It ain't nothing like North Hollywood. I'll tell you that right now. Yo, so who got it, man? I hate to cut you off. I'm just passionate about the situation. Germ Free or Top Time, man? Who got that?
Germ Free got that.
And I heard it was a little something after the battle.
Yeah, I mean, someone got a little heated because they got bars thrown at them, so they started throwing cups of water at them.
Was it during the battle? Or?
Right after the battle.
Right after the battle, just threw a cup of water at them?
Yeah, at her.
At her, yeah.
Yeah, shit was crazy, though.
Yo, so we were discussing before the show. What venue did you have that at?
Mid-City Art House. It's a UCLA venue. A lot of people never had events there. I've never been to an event there.
I do this for a living. I've never heard of it before. So.
Yeah, it's in Mid-City. It's like, shit's it's dope. Yeah. Dope as fuck. But you need to know someone from UCLA
you
to get
somewhere.
That. Yeah, you
got to
be in.
Nah, I'm with you, man. I'm with you. So when's your next event? What's going on next?
Working on July 18th. Looking for a venue. And we're going to get that cracking. Then I'm out to Mexico, coming back and looking for a big event.
Who does your flyers, man? Because I got to say, out of all the battle leagues, you guys have the dopest flyers right now. You got to see the flyers, man. It's dope. You got like this. They got like the Street Fighters. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like they're throwing Dento into Street Fighter and having him against somebody. And like you had the Simpsons last time and shit. You know what I'm saying?
The Simpsons. Oscar was the one that started doing that. He draws them out and shit. So.
Yo, can I get a battle? I'll learn some Spanish.
You look like you speak Spanish, man.
That would be dope. What if I fooled everybody?
That would be great,
probably,
dude.
You Puerto Rican, probably.
Yeah, you're Puerto Rican, right?
Man. No, I'm aloha, man.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, yeah. I remember the long wavy hair and everything. I got you.
Hey, I'm black, though. I'm black, though. Hawaiian.
Just 100% black.
Black.
Hawaiian,
Hawaiian
black.
Samoan people.
My people's got Cuban in them.
Yeah, I feel you, man. Yo, I never even.
Real quick, fast, man. What are the most annoying questions you get in interviews and shit? Like, did they ever tell you you like Nipsey Hussle and shit like that? Some dumb shit like that.
People be saying that you look like Nipsey Hussle. That's the weirdest thing.
I don't think he looks like Nipsey. He has like the same skin complexion, but
yeah, I don't think I look like Nipsey Hussle.
No, I mean, I wasn't the same. I was just as. Point of reference, like dumb questions that you got like that.
People be asking me dumb.
Maybe asking questions like that, right? Yo, man, do you get that? What questions do you get? I'm not trying to be a dick. I know everyone thinks I'm an asshole, but there's some people that
about,
think that
like,
you're.
What is grind time doing and shit?
Yeah, like the questions I asked you 5 minutes ago. I mean,
yeah, no. It's just like
pretty much.
Most of those questions and shit.
People have to think
that
you're mad.
I hate when people
son,
ask
right?
me about my homies, like
all the time.
Who better between me and my homies?
Oh yeah,
I hate that. Like, what you want me to say? They'd be like, who
they
you
want
think
you
better?
To say
you and Danny Myers. Who you think better? You think you could beat Daylight? Like, you think you could beat Dre Vicious? Like,
hey,
these is my niggas. You
know, but that's
who won? You or G4?
I ain't gonna lie. I served G4, though. That's my homie. But I beat him, and I didn't write no bars.
So let me ask you a question. What's the last battle you think you lost?
I never lost a battle.
You never lost a battle?
I ain't never lost a battle.
I heard Rum Nitty
never lost. You heard what?
Lost.
I heard Rum Nitty beat him.
Oh, Rum Nitty?
The game knows Rum Nitty.
Yeah.
It's like a certified fact. People say that to him in his battles. They be like, you lost to Cali Swim. Nobody's ever said anything like that to me.
I feel you, man. So, up to this point, what is your what battle are you most proud of? Is it the John battle? Just because everything that happened?
Because
you've been crazy booked, man. You've been crazy booked the last 12 months.
Yeah, a few battles I couldn't do. But Yeah, King of the Dot. Actually, my Danny Myers is my favorite new battle.
Yeah, I thought it was crazy.
That was crazy. Yeah, it ain't out on YouTube.
When's that dropping, man?
June 25th, I believe.
Man, I hope that one was crazy. I was in the house. But
it was crazy, man. Danny Myers, like, we was like, you know, we gonna put on a show, bro. You feel me? That's my big bro. But we was like, you know, we gonna put everything to the side, and we gonna like give it to him like it's supposed to be done. We gonna show everybody we the best in here, and we did. We went crazy on each other. But still, though, you feel me? I came out with that W on that one.
So you feel you got that victory over Danny?
You said you got Danny, too?
Yeah,
so
I did.
Gally ain't ever lost, man.
Hey, I ain't going to lie, though. I ain't going to lie. Me and Danny was a dope battle, but I took that W, though. And everybody felt it in the room because it's so Danny Myers is a loved battle rapper.
Hey, motherfuckers, you know, love Danny, dude.
That's because
he walks so hard. Though. He walks his ass off.
They wanted him to beat me.
Yeah,
it was expected.
I can see that.
Everybody knew he was going to beat me. They didn't think. They knew he was going to beat me. So when it happened after the battle, everybody was just kind of like, it's debatable. Yeah. Oh, it's debatable. And then nobody talk about it. Nobody talk. But if he beat me, though, everybody, Danny Myers just swept him. I knew you know what I mean?
You feel like you get a lot of hate, man? Because I feel like you get a lot of hate. I feel like you get a lot of hate.
I think it's the light skin syndrome.
I think it's light skin syndrome, too. I think it's light skin syndrome. You had a long wavy hair. I'm being dead serious right now. And, you know, most battle rappers, big, fat, ugly niggas.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and
I'm
being dead serious. And you got those pictures with your shirt off and everything. You know what I'm saying? And I think you get a lot of hate. I mean, that's who you are. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I feel like you got a lot of hate from it, man. You think it just comes from that?
I think it comes from that. I think it comes from in other states. They use, like, different slang and they talk different. So when they hear how L.A. people talk, they think we talk proper.
Oh, right? Some of it comes from the fact that you're from L.A.?
Yeah, it's a lot because I'm from L.A. And people like to choose. They latch on things to leech on and just like build on hate. I really don't understand
that's
it.
That's what I'm saying. I step back a lot from that shit because it was just a bunch of trolling. You feel me?
Yeah, it is. But when I'm at events, it's
all
love.
Battle rap is stand on stage calling you a faggot.
I'm talking about trolling on the YouTube page. It's cool. I mean, it's expected. But when you just latch it on to, you start like your own group about hating on this other group and then on some other shit.
Yo,
it's just when it goes
like that shit. The Clips 3-0 shit. That shit was stupid.
Clips 3-0 on every battle.
Clips has never lost a battle before, so that's of course that's different.
But real talk though, when I started in battle rap, I had nobody blocked on my Facebook page. I wish I could show y'all the list right now. Like just from being in the groups, I got like
stacks,
I ain't gonna lie, like probably about 100 people blocked. Cause I don't argue or nothing.
Wish I had argue with blocked. I don't get that much.
They'll say something really crazy or really stupid.
Fall back
like
from that Facebook.
It'll be like, whoa, this dude's crazy.
If I was a battle rapper, I probably wouldn't have a Facebook. You know what I'm saying? Cause it's easy for a dude in Ohio to act up over the keyboard. You know what I'm saying? Send you a message.
The only reason I do is because I keep in touch with. I grew up in like Chicago. I went to high school in Chicago and stuff. So I keep in touch with all my folks. We got pictures and stuff, and that I don't want to lose and miss and stuff. I just do it for like my fam.
What's some of the craziest messages or shit that you've got over the internet, like on Facebook or Instagram? I want to hear the craziest one.
I'm gonna tell you the craziest one. It's a true story. I blocked him too. So some dude hits me up, right? And I posted a picture of me coming out. I was in the hospital, like I told you. In the hospital, I was like, you know, I'm getting better, maintaining. Got this battle book, John and Don coming up. I'm gonna get up and I'm gonna do this for my folks. You know what I mean? I'm gonna do it with the broken arm. I said all that in the post, right? Hundreds of likes on Facebook. A dude hits me up in the inbox on a wheelchair. His picture, all his pictures, he's on a wheelchair. His legs are short, and he's like, "Yo, Cali, you doing this handicap is like inspiring for me to see. It's inspiring for me to see you doing this handicap, bro, because you're doing your thing." And I was like, "Oh man, you know I appreciate that, man. That's what I do this for. I do this to inspire." Tell me why this nigga sent me back a picture of myself in the ER with my next battle is the paramedics. And he was like, psych, I lied. Suck my dick, faggot. You whack as fuck. And I was like, and I sent him a message back and I said, you know what? I'm going to be the bigger man and walk away. And then I blocked him. And then he was hot. He was hot, though.
Yo, that has to be tough, though, not to respond. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, it was crazy. I laughed, though. Because I went to his page. I was like, is he really a pyramid? I looked through his pictures. I was like, yo, he's really on a wheelchair. He took time. Think of this one. I'm finna just block you real quick.
That's crazy, man. That's crazy.
I ain't about to talk crazy to him.
What's the craziest shit you ever got, man? Because I got to know that you get shit all the time, right?
Shit, man. I felt back from a lot of that bullshit ass conversation, because look, it mostly was a lot of things from the separation from what is Daily Duels, you know what I mean, a lot of things and shit, a lot of people from LA. It was like a lot of little beer leagues popping up like Daily Duels and shit, and we did it, you know what I'm saying. We did a lot of, shout out to Kat, she let us do a lot of things in the basement, and they were successful, you know what I mean, which in that one platform a lot of the individuals hit like a bigger stages, like, you know what I mean?
And everyone needs a place to start off at, right?
And yeah, that of course.
To be the place for a lot of cats.
On everything. I mean, I met Denter just because of battles and shit. I think I booked him and I fucking recorded on some bum ass fucking camera. He has like a battle out there with Renegade and shit on some like 8 megapixels per second and shit.
Oh,
so,
man.
That was like pixelized and shit. You know what I mean?
It probably looks a lot better.
Nah, you know what I mean? Everything was like from those levels. But it was a lot of them cats that were kind of like thorns in the game. Like, you know what I mean? I don't like to name their names and shit, but you know, everyone knows.
This is the B-side show for okay. This is what we do, baby.
You already know Speak.
This is what we do.
Like, Speak the Boy Holla.
You know what I'm saying? I think everyone agrees
that motherfucker has the award of the motherfucking Troll Awards. Like, if there was the Troll Awards, you know how they have like Jerry West on the NBA logo and shit? Like, the Troll Awards should be that nigga, like, straight up. Like, on everything I love.
What is he be doing as trolling?
I mean, if you know a lot of like the backstory of like a lot of, you know what I mean, just like general pop with the people from the battle scene in LA, like, you know what I mean, he's always picked fights online and shit, like, you know what I'm saying, picking, choosing and shit like that. He's got it into it with Lush and then and shit. You commented on shit, you probably blown and shit, you probably forgot about, you know what I mean, you know, it's some random people, you know what I mean, you fight with a lot of random people on Facebook, like, you know what I'm saying. That's why I stepped away from the Facebook groups of battle rap, because it's just like very
later. Like, you got a tour with him, I did be like, for real.
I mean,
I feel you, man. So,
but I mean, it's just like moving forth with that, like your show. It's like, you know what I mean, you come in here with thoughts of like individuals having a conversation about battle rap. I mean, that's moving forward the culture. Not like, you know what I mean, Denter has a Spanish league, you know what I mean, bringing it to a whole new culture that could tap into the general culture. You know what I'm saying? You know, they got to get in the Ingles Sin Barreras and. Then, you know what I mean, they'll get onto the Loaded Lux type of shit. But I mean, you know what I mean, there's a lot of things going on with the Spanish culture getting into battle rap. Like, it's a worldwide thing. It's gonna hit.
You think Spanish battle rappers get overlooked? Dante, you think they get overlooked in mainstream battle rap? You don't think so?
Mainstream battle rap, I mean, we're like the
shit.
We're like the flip top of this shit. Like, why would we get overlooked when we got just as many views? We got just as many events. We got just as many people in the events. Like, they really, realm. It's like, it could be bigger. Like, you got all these other countries that speak Spanish. It's huge, bro.
Old crippled countries that speak huge. Spanish.
Yeah. Is the Spanish media that picks it up?
No media. It's all word through underground. All word through social media.
Those are the major cosigns, though, right? You got, like, Send Dog fucks with your shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Young Baka fucks with your shit. You got a lot of major cosigns, too. So, you know. All hey,
we're white. Haven't seen him at an event.
I ain't getting invited.
Yo, you need to come with that shit. With the whole Hawaiian language. Aloha and
yeah,
shit.
On me, though. That's why the event. The events, like he said, it's on a smack level. The one I'm doing in Oahu. It's like, it's gonna be like 3-4 thousand people in the building. You feel me?
No, I mean, but I see your shit though. Like every time that you go to Hawaii, it's slap for you.
It's
like,
slap, you know, every time I go. You feel me? Shout out to my Hawaii folks. You know, my buzz bigger out there than it is out here. I got a song on the radio.
True.
Out here.
How'd you hook? How did that happen? Are you from Hawaii?
That's a good question though, Bob. Like over there, like, you know, that's how. Is it different from the mainland and shit? Like, yo, because
I think it's way different, right? Just because they're disconnected.
The whole everything is a whole different way. I went out there for a music tour in 2014. I did the South by Southwest. I opened up for Nas and ASAP Rocky, and then like the next week I went out to. No, actually, the next week I battled Rum Nitty, and the next day after I battled Rum Nitty, I went to Hawaii for my first tour out there, and then we did like. Four clubs, and then we went to the radio station. I told the lady, like, yeah, I'm Hawaiian, I just never been out here, and then she was just like loving it. So we talked, we bonded, everything was cool. And I did a song while I was out there called Hawaii Anthem, and I was just playing. I was in the studio out there. The homie was playing his ukulele, and we just recorded it. She liked it. She spun it. She spun another song called All On Me. And they kept spinning it when I left. And then I got hit up when I left, like about a month later. He was like, yo, they spinning your song out here. Like, people know who you are and stuff. I was like, that's what's up. It was like they're watching your battles and everything. Somebody hooked me up with this promoter that they was doing this big show at the biggest event, the biggest venue on Oahu. It's called Blaisdell Hall. It's on Waikiki Beach, and it was like a big thousands of people in the crowd and stuff. I was opening up for my homegirl Jazzy. I did a song with her. We shot the video in Hawaii, and it just ended up on Worldstar. That was crazy too. But I went out there for the show. Blaisdell Hall was packed, fully packed. Stupid love in Hawaii. Then they hit me up for the battles.
So the twist time.
I'm going out there for.
I've been using that shit all fucking day to get these off. And he'll twist us.
Yo. That's when you know he's a rookie drinker. Yo, man. He doesn't know that. Shit. Rolling Rock is not a twist off.
I don't know, man. We still looking for our sponsors, man.
Baca, any American beer is a twist off.
I was stunned right now. Like, nobody told me that.
Oh, it was a twist off? Yo, I didn't know that.
We from Hawaii, though. It's cool.
Yeah, we got it. We got to take
a break. So it's like a whole different country with a country.
Yeah, it is a whole different country. That's what people do need to acknowledge, that Hawaii got bought by America. You feel me? So it's so Americans moved in. But what other state has its own culture, has its own language?
California.
You know, we don't have our own language. Yes, Puerto Rico.
Fuck?
Come on, man.
We don't got our own language.
We don't got
no. Trust me. Puerto Rico, we have our own language.
We don't got our own language.
I mean, in California, a lot of people, because in the type of the shit that I do in the real world.
You can talk to a nigga from New York right now.
Yeah, I'll talk to a real. They're the only ones that talk faster.
I think New York has a different, more distinct slang than we do.
They talk faster, but we talk faster.
They just got a slang, bro.
No, then Baltimore. Niggas, they talk crazy.
Why you think Cali has its own language? I don't think we're that different, man. To be honest with you,
it's bad. Cause
we're a mesh. I mean, it's different from like a Latino perspective and shit. Like, you know,
why
what I'm
is
saying?
That different?
Because, like, you know, what I mean, it's a whole different look. Like, you know, what I mean, because we blend with where we are located by. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of heads that I grew up with. You know what I'm saying? They're from South Central, Mexican descent. They be like, yo. You know what I mean? You talk like you're from you ghetto and shit. Like, you have that ghetto slang and shit. Like, you know what I mean? And then you have that East LA, what's up? You know what I mean? Like, that whole different. You know, there's different Mexicans. Like, the Valley Mexicans is different from the East Side Mexicans. It's
just a little bit different slang, though. You know what I'm saying? Different words here and there. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean? Because it doesn't sound the same. Straight up. Especially, too, when you mix or that like that. Like, you know what I mean? LA is its world within the world. Within a world, you know what I mean, it's. But I mean, when you mix in that battle rap culture, it's like perfect weather. You know what I mean, especially to the culture, to aspect one. You know, shout out, salute to him, because you know when he had the double R season, he had Venice popping the whole West Side. A lot of people from the East Side start fucking with the West Side. We haven't seen them in years. We would have not hit that bus lick all the way across town just to watch a battle and shit, you know what I mean, in people's hometowns, and then they start following us and fucking with us, and you know what I mean, that, you know how that, that's why when LA got a little smaller, like, I mean, with battle rap for us.
Yeah, you know, you think that shit's missing though? You think that community of battle rap's missing? Because I know we discussed it earlier. It was segregated. You eat a Rockfish Fresh Coast over here, or you one of those cats that fuck with Grind Time, or you're one that's of the new URL motherfuckers.
We trying to disappear, you know, all those lines. I mean, that when I step back, I mean, I saw rap from a different point of view. Like, it needs to stop being drawing lines in the sand and shit. Start thinking of like, yo, who has a long-standing fucking contract with a major television company or a production company?
But see, there's not nobody. A lot of, like, there's not URL, a lot of cats that think URL like you, though. You know what I'm saying?
Like, I mean, yeah. But that's the thing. Like, you have to think in that level. You got to fuck with each
but
other.
But there's not a lot of people that think there's that way, though. You know
money.
What I'm saying?
There's global money. There's money over there. There's money over here. If everybody stopped fucking drawing long, you know that shit? Like, oh, we only fuck because you can't have a contract with so-and-so company. You have 3 battles over here. You are X'd out in the, you know what I mean? It's crazy. It's crazy. And booking.
So what do we do to change it, though? We know the problem. It sucks, money. But what do we do to change it? How do you get the money, though? That's easy to say.
Look, what it best suits how the game is right now is what's standing behind us. It's Hollywood as fuck.
It's like battle rap just sells out and goes to Hollywood, and we just do our thing.
I mean, look, with Snoop coming in the game. Because
I think what Dento's doing is more impressive and more advancing the culture than anything else. We get that whole Spanish population involved.
What Dento's doing is amazing because it's touching a whole culture that didn't know a lot about this. You know what I mean?
So now then they check out these Spanish battles, and they're like, oh, yo, let me check this. Let me check this out. Let me check this Smack battle out, too. Oh, yo, this is the King of the Dot battle. You know what I'm saying? That's just how shit happens,
but think
dude.
About how dope it would be if, like, the dopest Mexican battle rapper battles the dopest British battle rapper, but they're in a tournament with an American battle rapper.
I mean, isn't that what War Dominations is?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, King
there's
of the
no Mexican world
avenues,
domination,
baby.
Yeah, man. Well, we gotta change that, don't you? I think that's outrageous. There's no Mexican world domination.
It'd be much more wavy if everybody had a conglomerate channel where everybody had their own stream.
So you like think one
URL and King of the Dot and Grind Time. If they put all their money up, baby, we'd be Trump style.
But it doesn't work that way, though. You know what I'm saying? So you have to have a boss. You have to have a CEO who's in charge. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, like, everybody does their own thing. That's why I say I fell back from the game. I try to see, like, yo, nobody wants to do it. I'm just going to have to build it. You know, it's like, you know, like that movie and shit. If they build it, they will come and shit. Like, you know what I mean? He thought he was crazy out there just building shit by himself. I had to step away from the whole culture in L.A. because it was just got troll-like. It was just like, yo, I can't fuck with y'all.
Just,
because,
I think that's how white is, though.
You
feel me?
This is a King of the Dot event. I'm like, what?
What do you mean?
I feel you. I'm sure.
We see riding the B riding over here. What's up?
So what you're saying in the perfect planet, King of the Dot, URL, everybody puts their talents together and they create one battle channel.
They have their own battle channel.
But why would Smack
buy your
own
fucking channel?
Why would King of the Dot want to do that? If you say, yo, Young
because
Baka,
it benefits
I'm saying,
all of them.
Young Baka Productions is out here killing shit. You guys are doing dope. But yo, these other casts over here are killing as well. Why don't you guys come together?
Because the real world don't give a fuck about rap.
But what I would say, I disagree because we've been killing it lately, you know what I'm saying? It just equals the money. What I would say is, that's cool. They doing that over there.
I mean, we got pumped up when Dre got a Billy. I mean, you know what I'm saying? The rap game, but like, think about battle rap. It's in an infant stage of like the underground scene.
I don't think it's at an infant stage anymore. There's no way.
We just had
Velasco's popping. There's no way it's still at an infant stage. You know what I'm saying?
No. I mean, it's an infant stage of what's going to be in the coming years. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about like, this is barely, they were born. Like, the time frame where I'm looking at from, it was like, it was still in the womb growing. And now it's just like birthed a lot of dope companies like, you know, King of the Dot. You know what I mean? A lot of them, you know what I mean? What Organic has done. Yo, people to Canada, you know what I'm saying? They fucking with us over there. You know what I mean? Grind Time started a lot of things from them. You know what I mean? A lot of people don't understand that at first, a lot of things in Canada were a Grind Time North type of shit. You know what I mean? And it kind of brought to that. Like, especially too, when I had a conversation with Mad Ills, especially with PH, you know, RIP. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man. Rest in peace to PH. We didn't even talk about that, man.
And we was kind of like, you know, bringing up, you know, stories about him. You know, because it was that time frame, but damn, when we just barely learned about that shit, and it was like, yo. So, you know, we try to build on those stories that we had with him. Now he brought a lot of valid points to me and shit. He told me that it's always best just to fall back at times. You know what I mean? Because it gets too much. Like, there's too many individuals consumed in this, in the battle right world. But if they see the bigger picture where they can own that content, because it's all about owning that content. Because every time you upload to YouTube, guess who is getting the bigger portion of that slice?
Yeah, that's life, that's life, man. Yo, with that being said, let's take a quick break. You know what I'm saying? Pay all bills and everything. Be set show form. Stay the battle rap.
Whoa.
No bacon, but mandatory circumcision.
Who's there? You decide!
These robot nuts! I'm gonna enjoy watching you die! Let me do it, get my over.
Because you're standing over the rank orbit.
Now stand up and rhyme. I only thought you out so I could beat your ass a second time. Roar like Chewbacca, the voice of Mufasa.
We're back in the B-side show, State of Battle Rap, alongside with Denter, Knock Steady, Cali Smooth. Man, appreciate it, dude. So, yo, you got your new album coming out?
Oh, no, it's out, man. It's out. Let's go. Independently Mainstream, man. I got some platinum producers on this thing. I gotta get one of my boy DJ Myth. You feel me? Got some dope engineers. Got my boy Fingers on this thing. J Classic. Couple people, man. You feel me? Some good music on here, man.
The people in the green room having a better time than us.
Yeah, man. Motherfuckers be balling and shit, man. That's what we do, man. Peace out, show for them. People come in, we chill, you know what I'm saying? Dudes smoke, drink, you know what I'm saying? Apparently, we watch Pulp Fiction as well, so. But yo, man,
shout out to that, man. Everybody gotta come out here, man, and support the B-side shop, for real. Like.
B-side shop. Man. I don't know the address offhand.
Plug that off the
gotta
top.
Come through. B-side
yo,
shop.
I'm pretty sure, like, hey, teleprompter right there, just right across.
Yeah, we promote it, man.
how long you been doing your music, man? What's going on with this? Yo, what did I see these? I saw these on Plague Beats and Rhymes. I saw your sticker.
Oh, what?
Yeah, man, Plague Beats and Rhymes. I showed up like 3 o'clock in the morning. I saw a Cali Smooth sticker. I took a picture of it. I was going to send it to you, man. Make sure we get that.
Where is Plague Beats and Rhymes?
What city is that?
It's off Cahuenga.
Yeah, off Cahuenga. They got the underground hip hop show between 1 and 5 a.m. I saw a Cali Smooth sticker right there, man.
That's dope, man. I got.
So you never been to Plague Beats and Rhymes?
Nah, I got a few homies out here that's running around with like thousands of these. So I gotta call them and thank them again.
Yeah, man, we gotta like get you. We gotta get you booked for all that shit. So yo, where you gonna be performing this Friday night, man?
Oh man, I'm at the Airliner, man. It's me and a lot of people that y'all got, that y'all know, you feel me?
Hey, man.
I'm going to turn it out, leave with 200 real quick.
Speaking of that, best performance of the night gets $200. You know, we're thinking about giving $1,000 away next month, but that's something different and shit, you know? But yo, man, I'm excited to have you back.
I appreciate that,
yeah,
too.
Man. Definitely. You know, you were, I think you were like on We The West 5 or something like that. You know what I'm saying? You killed it. We appreciate it. We've been trying to work it out for a while now, so we're happy to have you back, man.
Hey, yeah, man.
You make good music, too. I wouldn't book you if you didn't make good music. You know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of rappers out here.
I did. The last show that you booked me on was super dope. It was a lot of people there.
And that was a year ago. We've grown hundreds of times since then. You know what I'm saying? Bigger venues, bigger names. It was a long time ago, man.
Yo, that's
like I said, you used to have the big wavy hair and shit. So
Yeah, I did.
A little jealous. I was hating, but it's all good, dude. What you got coming up, man? I know you're working with this app and everything. And you got your shoe game cracking. I'm going to need a hookup.
Man, for real, man. I ain't trying to plug it in, but you know what I'm saying? That's why I've been dabbling when I was on my vacation from the whole battle scene, but... Yeah, man, we actually gonna open up a shop in Pomona.
Nice, dude.
That's gonna have some with the whole consignment shop, and we try to do the whole art district thing because it's gonna be right next to the Glass House, and you know what I mean, we from Pomona town, you know what I mean, it's about an art district. It's like the far east of the whole you know, LA County and shit. You know what I mean? It's the last stop we go ahead and feel. And
I think
vibrate,
you said Pomona's Inland Empire, right? We had a conversation last time.
You said that.
Because it's Inland Empire, right?
No, you
it's
said
Empire.
This.
Yo,
no,
it
ain't
it's,
IE.
It's Inland
not
Empire.
IE, bro.
I stand by it, too. I don't back
it's
up.
Not
that
IE.
Shit.
It's not
IE.
It's
but go
not
ahead.
IE, bro.
It's
not IE,
step
bro.
On this shit. Go ahead.
It's not IE. It's just like the Valley's not LA.
I'm from
the Valley's not LA. It's the Valley. It's the Valley. It's the Valley.
San Gabriel Valley, bro.
San Gabriel Valley ain't the Valley either. I'll tell you that right now, man.
We
all
it's
called SGV.
When you thinking of opening that up, man, doing your thing.
Yeah, we just working it out with the landlord, but it's gonna be like somewhere in August. I mean, the whole thing is like the sneaker shop is gonna have like the battle scenes and shit like that. So I open up my doors for any battle league that's trying to have an event there. Because that's what I want to see. You know?
Not any battle league. You got to be selected, man. I'm sick of battle leagues popping up. Right?
Oh, I'm not going to talk. Okay.
Let if me they specific. Be good.
They pay yeah, you good for you because you get more battles, nigga.
You know, I should
but
just
I
got to
see some whack battles on YouTube. The only new battle leagues I fuck with is IE Fall. My boy Epic
Infamous
killed it.
Battles.
You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Infamous Battles. And, you know,
I mean,
I can't pronounce your battle league.
Whatever
battle league is, I can't pronounce. We fuck with it.
All of them individual leagues and shit, I can't fit them in my place because they too big now.
Yeah, no, I agree.
So all the up and coming ones and shit, it's all about the mom and pop shop, man.
I agree.
Come on, man. Let's all like build on the fact like they come out of these minor leagues and they try to migrate into like
but
that. Maybe one of them.
There should only be a few minor leagues, though. There should only be a few minor leagues. We can't have 10 minor leagues.
You battle with assault battling, right? You battle with small leagues.
Yeah.
He was
before
in
y'all attack these leagues, let's attack these garbage battle rappers who accept these battles and do mediocre performances.
Like who?
And then everybody
like
be like,
Like who, Cali?
I'll start naming names.
What
is
this it? Why I get everybody drunk every week?
Just
who's
don't
doing
say that? Y'all see Averb every time you get on a little league.
Yo, but I feel like when Averb's on his shit, though,
he's never on his shit.
Yo.
Everybody say the same shit.
Him against Danny?
Averb's on
his shit. Yo. Danny Miles was Averb. He was on his shit.
Averb
he killed
was ass.
Him.
His third round. His third round was terrible.
You up here, Epic. You up here.
Bro, he ass.
His third round was terrible.
He's Danny Miles, bro.
People have bad rounds.
Jeez.
I agree. People have bad rounds.
You can't say he killed it.
I think he won.
If he had a terrible
round. You think A4 beat Danny Miles?
I could freestyle right now.
A-verb's ass.
You think Danny Miles beat A4?
Yes.
A-verb's ass.
You guys are unbelievable.
Bro, I hate this URL syndrome. I'm going to tell you what the URL syndrome is. If it ain't on Smack, it don't count. I'm going to tell you what the URL syndrome is.
If it ain't on Smack,
it don't count. The URL syndrome is if you've been on Smack, you're better than you really are. You feel me? People say to me, John is debatable because he's been on Smack. You feel me? People say A-Verb is amazing and a legend because he's been on Smack.
I mean, he's dope.
If these niggas A-Verb existed.
Is dope.
A-Verb is dope.
A-Verb
is dope, but he's not better than Danny Meyer.
He's not nice.
He's not better than me. He's not better than a lot of these young, hungry niggas out here.
But you can't say anybody's better than anybody because on any given Sunday, you could be beat, right? Or do you think just someone's just flat out better?
Yeah, I think people are flat out.
No, I don't think that's true. Because I think some
rap.
Of your battles are better than some of your previous. Some of your rounds are better than. So how could you say that anyone's just flat out better?
You're right. But I think some of these niggas don't even rap. They just battle rap. So
it's
they're
battle
not
rap,
good
that's
to
what
me.
You're supposed to do.
They're not good to me. Like they do this. Denture, tell me if I'm lying. They do the beer bottle I rock and roll
yeah,
in the
whack.
Building
that's
with the
whack.
Beer in. But
that's
they do that,
though.
And that's the worst thing in the whole world.
No one's
like, is
no
that
one doing punchlines anymore?
Before Smack, before PG, is that really how you rap?
Bro, nobody
that's
doing punchlines anymore. No
but
one's
for
garbage.
The first time, for the first time ever, there's battle. There's people that have grown up watching battle rap with no intentions of making music, simply to be a battle rapper. That's where that comes from.
That's where that comes from, and I feel like those people are garbage. You got
so you think every battle rapper has to make music?
Back in the day, it used to be like rappers battling each other. What if Nas battled Big Pun? You would hear a whole two different style of clashes. Now you're hearing the same people do the same thing to appease the same crowd.
So why do we book these people? Why do we watch these people's battles? Why do we keep giving them bags of money? I like A4. I like A4 style, but he gets booked a lot. Why does he keep getting booked? He's so ass. This is what we do, baby. B-Sash your form.
Battle rappers now are sounding like a cover band. They're just doing the same shit.
It's like Def Poetry,
shit.
Bro.
I wouldn't be surprised if you see a couple more motherfuckers sounding like Carter Deems. Like, you're going to see that in a couple
fucking. Oh, the Carter Deems copycats are coming. They're coming for sure.
Nobody has no originality.
So how do we change this? What do? We know the problem. How do we solve it?
Man, we turn off the internet.
You ain't never turn off the internet.
I know how you solve it.
If you're a little mom and pop league, you don't book A-Verb when you know he's going to come with one written round and he's going to freestyle his other two. You know what I'm saying? You stop giving him bags of
money. Localized though.
Charlie Clips is dope though. So it's different.
Like you gotta understand it. Like
he
battle rap.
A lot of people.
Battle rap has already globalized. So
John Don, he comes with his shit.
So we can't stop it. We accept that we're gonna have to watch these whack ass battles.
The thing is, like, the people just gotta stop being like scared of supporting individuals and shit like that.
Bro, I don't think. Why do we have to support people?
Cause
we
it's
don't
the word,
have to support
the word
people.
Dick rider
when
and
I,
shit.
When I but when I do shows
like,
in LA,
oh, you support so and so, you a dick rider,
and everyone says, oh, you gotta come out and show support. Come out, don't come out and show support. If you put out good music, people gonna come fuck with you.
People
that's
show
how it
support
be.
If you they get in for free.
That's how it should be, man. That's how it should be. If you put out good music, people gonna come. Facebook got people tripping, man.
All these battles, I
like the aggressive drunk Cali smooth. You know what I'm saying? I like that standing up on your chair. I like it, man.
Yeah, I got me too.
Bro, all these battles coming out right now, they're ass. Like,
how do we stop it?
How many battles are you excited for? Hollow the Don versus fucking Charlie Clips was ass.
I think Hollow did good. I love Charlie Clips. It ain't debatable.
Was it terrible or not?
Was it
real?
First round was
bro. Was it what
the
you expected? Was
the psych I lied t-shirts? Come on, yeah.
This is why. This is why it won't change. Was that battle ass? Was that battle ass?
No, it was not.
Charlie Clips was weak.
Yeah, Charlie Clips.
Hollow was weak.
Both of them was weak. I'm the biggest Charlie Clips fan you'll find.
Both of them were weak, bro. Charlie Clips. He said, I got a little bitch to sing at niggas and bitches. I call it Days Low. Like, that's your punchline, bro, for No on 5.
I'm the biggest Charlie Clips fan.
I think it was whack.
What the fuck you mean you see
it?
The fuck does that mean, dog? fuck out of here, dude. So what do? We just accept that we're going to have a million whack battle rappers and we just got to...
It's the internet.
We need to get... People are proud of that PG Step stuff. You know, Daylight did that to make fun of niggas.
And dudes...
Daylight did that like, y'all stupid with the... And then people were like, yeah, I PG Step with it. Like, y'all proud of that?
I hate the new PG with Smack. I hate all the new...
I hate Baca, my nigga. That's why I came here, bro.
I mean,
look, we need to X him out. We need to do something, bro. We need to make a petition.
I mean, we have to find the balance, though. We have to get new cash.
Bro, I'm
supporting them.
You battle right now. Snoop Dogg hit you up right now and said, "Yo, I want to set you up in a battle, but at the same time, you get a call from Def Jam saying they want to sign you to a record deal. Which one are you gonna hop on first? Like, really?
I just did a battle for Snoop Dogg.
So I mean, so you'll hop on.
Def Jam doesn't sign people no more.
I'm using a reference.
But nah, I mean, music, like, where though, the music. Battle rapper. I'm not a battle rapper. I'm a musician that can battle. I'm a musician that got into battle rap. You feel me?
I see there's a lot of battle rappers that have no intention of making music, and that's where some of this stuff comes from.
Yeah, that's why. Why is that weird?
Someone wants to be a battle rapper. Hollow's made a great living off being a battle rapper.
It's not that. I think that's dope. Be a battle rapper, make a great living off of it. But if you have no like cloth and you're doing this to emulate other battle rappers, that's when it gets whack. That's when you look up to Hollow the Don and you want to sound like him and not Nas, then that's when it's like, all right, this is getting whack, hey man, and not authentic.
Corny.
So how long ago was Hollow for Big T? It was probably 14, 15 years ago now?
No, man. It was like 6, 5,
like 09, okay,
so let's say it's, I think it was like 08, though. Let's say it's 08. So let's say it's 08. Okay. 7 years ago, you're 9 years old. You're 16 years old now. You have to sound like Hollow. You're whack, bro.
No, you're trash. Now you got to do something and reinvent yourself.
Something different?
Like, it's just like, it's no originality, bro. You know what I'm talking about.
If you sound like anyone, period.
It's just like you sound like battle rap.
If you
sound like
battle rap, you're trying to find your voice.
Do y'all see the World Star battle rappers be like,
yeah,
I come through my kitchen with the Siri. Yo, they can do that about us now because of them niggas, man.
So how do we stop it? What do we do?
Stop supporting that shit. Smack stop supporting that
though.
Shit.
I ain't gonna lie. Shout out to Smack. No disrespect,
man,
but he supports that.
You just gonna have
shit.
To live with it.
I don't watch any battles anymore.
I hate when battle rappers say they don't watch battles.
I don't watch battles. I don't.
Because it makes you seem like you're so much better than battle rap. Like,
nah, it's not even that.
Crazy K says the same thing. I tell him he's a fucking asshole.
Oh,
I'm sorry. And Cali's all drunk. Watch out. Cali's drunk.
Hit the.
Alright.
It's just, why or not, when you watch a lot of it, that's just gonna stick to you.
Yeah.
That's why I don't watch it.
But that's habit, though. You're a product of your environment.
I don't watch battle rap.
No, that's like a boxer saying he doesn't watch boxing. I watch battle. Thank you, bro.
Yeah, they watch a boxing match versus their opponent.
I definitely do study the game tape. Even though I enjoy battle rap. Battle rap is my favorite sport.
It's a sport, yeah.
Besides
exactly.
boxing. Like, battle rap is my favorite sport. So I do sit there and I do take my time to enjoy battle rap.
I'm just not excited for any new battles that come out because I know most of them are going to be a letdown.
I was super excited for Hollow versus Charlie Clemson.
It was a letdown.
And it was a big letdown.
No, I mean, like,
I was excited.
You're
going
to sit there an hour to watch it.
I was excited for Pat Safe as a Calico, and I feel like it lived up to everything it was made
yeah,
to be.
Yeah, me too.
It was super dumb. Did you watch Calico vs. Pat Safe?
I don't like Pat Safe. I don't like
it. I watched it live, and I was screaming.
Did you see Pat Safe as Calico? You see Pat Safe as Calico?
Well, I haven't. Look, I'm about to get into one. Like, everybody does that. They just, like, start watching all the battles at once. On some insomnic fucking night and shit.
Bro, I'd rather watch old battles than new ones.
Nah, man, you gotta stay
I'll go and rewatch old
updated,
battles.
Man.
That's
you
what I do.
You gotta stay updated. You don't think Michael Jordan watches LeBron James play? You have to do it.
Man, I don't know. LeBron, there's a time for separation where it's needed, where you need to build. For you to try to have something that you can put to the table where individuals could grow in the realm that you want.
You need to get away to have originality.
Yeah, exactly. If you have time to imagine, then you got to step back and imagine everything.
You sound like every other battle rapper.
That would happen when you watch all the battles. Like, you watch all the battles.
You'll come to that point.
It's natural.
Yeah, you'll come naturally.
If you watch, if you're a young kid playing basketball and you watch every single LeBron game.
But that ain't true, though.
If you watch every LeBron game, you're going to start styling your game after him. It's just
Because look at casts like John and Don.
Yeah.
But he was battling before it took off.
Look at Bricks Belvedere. Look at Cali Smooth, Danny Myers.
So I mean,
like, niggas don't sound like everybody else.
Danny Myers been battling for like 30 years. So it's like,
first of all, the one that jumped off with John the Don was with the dude Moneybags. Shout out Moneybags. That battle with Moneybags and John the Don really set off the tone for what he brought forth in the game. So, because a lot of things is the stigmatism that he had with old school battle rappers that said, oh, you bit my style. A lot of them MCs is like, you bit my style. And it's been like avalanche of storms of everybody jockeying. That's why when Cali...
everybody's still sounding like the Suns right now.
Yeah. Hey, man. Everybody. I think it's natural. Me, myself, I don't know how you stop these whack dudes from coming to the game, especially if you want to have mom and pop leagues. You want to get booked for it. You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is.
It's a popularity I'm just saying, game, no.
I know what you're trying to say, Buck. I mean, there's going to be a standard of individuals getting invited to the.
You can't. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I think it should be standard. If you want to get on We the West stage, we gotta listen to your music. You gotta start off on stage one and move your way up. You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
That's just how life is, dude. What you got coming up, man? Let's get about it here. We're all drunk. Shit. You look like shit. What's going on?
August 1st, IE Evolve going down to Corona. Epic 9 over throwing that shit. Now, I mean,
I told him he's not allowed to do a show at the same venue. So we're going to talk about that.
Is it Corona?
Well, I don't know what it is.
Yo, Epic 9. Oh, Epic Saga. I'm sorry. Epic Saga is in the building.
Pomona.
It's not 9 over.
What is it?
What do you want, Pomona?
Throw something in here, bro.
We're going to Pomona. Man, this is what we had called the Beans versus Urban Element. We had it right here.
I have a meet and greet in here.
Man. Yeah, man. Let's set it up, man.
We have that coming up. 10 August 1st. I'm also going to be out there in Mexico battling.
There you go.
Battling.
When is it? August?
August 1st. I'm battling out there.
I'm going with you. We're going to go to Mexico.
Can you come back?
What do you mean? I don't know if I come back. Yeah, of course I come back, motherfucker. All right. So, Knox, you open up a store. You got your battle in Hawaii coming up. And me and you going to go to Mexico. Sounds like a plan.
Good.
You could come back.
Yo, man.
Good time.
Closing line.
Yo, man.
Soon to Black Sheep Club. Follow that.
This is Young Baka. B-Side Show Forum. Say the battle rap. Thank you, fellas, for coming through. We'll catch you next time. Young's Life.
Yeah. Peace.
Yeah!